Hello, welcome back to the channel. What you see in front of you and what you find as the template is a banner for Discord that you can post in a channel to act as a header for any information that you want to post below. If you're just looking for the template, you can find that in the description as a Google Drive link. And keep in mind, you'll also need the font. I'm using Open Sans. I forget if this is a default font that's included with operating systems, but if it isn't, that's also going to be linked below for you to download. And to download the font, you simply download the file. If it's in a zip, you have to unzip it, and then you go into that, and you double click on the .ttf or .otf file. It should pop up, and you can click install. You might also be able to right click and click install. I'm not sure about that, but I feel as if that would be an option. And I should note that I'm using Adobe Photoshop Creative Cloud. This is a paid software. It costs, I think, $20 a month for the photography plan, which is Lightroom and Photoshop. But if you're a student, I think you can get the entire suite for $25 or $30. And if you're not a student, then everything costs, I believe, in the $50 to $60 range, which is really pricey. Now, I suppose $25, $30, and even $20 is also quite a hefty amount to pay on a monthly basis. But if you don't have Photoshop or you can't afford Photoshop, which is totally understandable, there's a cool website instead called Photopia. Let me show you what that is. It, of course, does not have all of the same functionality as Photoshop. You can do much of the same, but lots of the other features just aren't up to par or are missing. But for this purpose and for most banners, it should work out really well. And as just an example, here it is. And it looks like Open Sans is a default font, but I'll still include it just in case. As you can see, everything loaded much of the same. And actually, let me do a quick test. I do want to mention, unlike other tutorials, this one isn't going to be a creation from the ground up. I'm simply going to go over how to make this string on the left, because I believe that's a little more complicated. Everything else is pretty straightforward, because it's just clipping and rectangles, to be frank. So let me test something real quick with the pen tool. Let's do shape. Actually, let's try no fill, red. Cool, yep, so we can do exactly that. Awesome. So if you don't want to go through the steps of how to make the string, just go down in the description, download the file. But other than that, I'm going to jump into how you can make the string section on the left. I will quickly pop open each of these files. The main area, I have the leaf shape as a separate center section, just so when I clip these leaves on, they are not going to the outside frame. And the texture itself, I have as a lighter color. Then for the main shape, I just have the base with the texture on chop, and that's just the outside section. I have the frame, and that is just a rectangle with a stroke, no fill, and then the edge, which is the left side, and it just has the edge piece, which I made from a regular rectangle. Then I cut the corners off the top and the bottom, and this simply has an inner shadow on it. I think that covers all of the stuff. Text just has a texture on it. And so now let me jump into the string. So the way I recommend you do the string is first grab the pen tool, make sure you create a new layer, and I'm using Alt and scrolling to zoom in or out. Then come over to this hole and let me actually hide my existing string. So I will sample the color real quick. Cool. And let me hide, where's that string? Top string, I'll hide that as well. And we're gonna make sure we're on pen tool, as I mentioned, and we are on shape. As for the shape, we're gonna go stroke and click the darker color we just picked. If it's not showing up in recently used colors, click this colorful little box. And you can click here or you can paste the hex code, whichever you chose. Now this can be a little difficult, but the pen tool is a tool you should really become familiar with if you're using Photoshop. So I'm gonna click here. I'm gonna click around the top. Oops, I messed that up completely. But as you can see, Actually, let's do it over here. I'm gonna twist it over there, and I'm gonna twist it over here. It's not looking all that great for a natural looking string, but I think you get the idea of how this works. It takes a lot of tinkering around to get it to look nice, but that will be our first layer. So we can create a new layer from here. And we're gonna fix all this stuff here in just a moment. And now we're gonna say this is going along the back. So now coming to the bottom, we're gonna click here. And we kinda wanna match this. So this would have gone this direction probably. I'm curving it back because I really want it to be in this corner. So maybe if you curve it yourself, try to curve it so where it points more down in this direction. Now I'm gonna start here. I'm gonna curve over to say here. And then I'm gonna loop up over here. And then loop up top over here. One important thing to note as well is you have to hold Alt and click this little piece at the ends and drag it to the center. Otherwise, it changes the way your line is curved. If we put it to the center now and try to curve it, it curves from that center location. But in this case, I might want it to be out a little bit so I can get a more natural looking little curve here at the ends. Not my best example, but then at the ends, you can take the leaf and just try to line it up so it looks as if it's a string at the end of the bookmark and this is a little piece at the end of it. Get that lined up. Great. That's just an example. Now we have to make sure we go and rasterize each layer. I totally didn't think that was the end of the tutorial right there. When it comes to the ends, we go down to the base of this frame and click delete when we're on the first shape. And now it looks as if it's coming out from the back. Now we go to the top, we go to this shape, and we delete here first. Make sure it looks like it's going behind. And then we come over here, and this section we'll use the pen tool again. Make sure you switch off of shape and go to path. Click here, try to curve it around to match the curve of the circle. Go all the way around, right click, make selection, click OK, click delete. This one's a little messy. It didn't quite stick to the edge as well as I would have liked, but you get the idea of how that should look. If you're feeling up for it, you can also add some little extra detail, such as a drop shadow, pattern overlay, bevels, whatever. But just keep in mind, it's supposed to be a string, so try to keep it in that format. Let's see what else would be helpful to know. I guess for this edge here, that was actually super simple to make. Let me undo all this because I do not want that. And then delete that, and let's reshow all of this. For this edge here, I simply took the background. I'm just going to make a new one real quick as an example. So I took the background, let's say it was this. And let's make sure we're on fill. No stroke, no curves. Let's actually fix the sizing a bit as well. It's a little too chunky for me. And then I right clicked, rasterize layer style, because keep in mind, if it's considered a shape layer, you're not going to be able to edit it. So make sure you rasterize it first. So it's no longer a shape layer. And how I had it here is it was poking out, but instead, what you can do is just do it right off like this. Click down, click to about here, go over, and then click to the top. Ideally, try to line it up, but it's not a big deal if you don't. Then make selection. We're going to do Control J, delete the one below. Control J just duplicate our selected area. And you're going to say, hey, we haven't done the bottom yet. Well, we're going to do Control J again, go to Control T. Control T being free transform, which you can find in edit and free transform. We're gonna go to our width and add a negative sign there. Go to our height, add a negative sign there. And actually, no, do not add a negative to the width, only add a negative to the height. Not sure what I was thinking. And you might have to adjust it because you made it too tall from the bottom, but now we have the top and the bottom cut exactly as we wanted it. Now just right click, merge down so it's one shape, and then just line it up with this. So line the top corner up to the edge there, and line the bottom corner to the edge there. You can see it's not the right size, but that's because I just made a random shape off of the side over here. I didn't base it off of what's already there. And I think that's all of it. For the leaves, it's pretty simple. It's just coloring it. You can sample the color from here. Just hold I over to the eyedropper tool. Either one works. Grab this brown and you have the color. And you simply color overlay and just clip it on, move it around. Now, these leaf shapes I grabbed were all free versions. There are some really nice free shapes, free leaf shapes out there. Okay, not free, but paid. And look really nice for patterns. I didn't feel like paying $14 or $15 or whatever for a leaf pattern just for this video. But I'll link a couple of those in the description as well if you want to consider buying these patterns for yourself. Not these on screen. Different patterns that actually look really nice. So other than that, I think that covers everything. If you found this helpful, please like and subscribe. And other than that, I hope you have an awesome day.